We all know about Elon Musk. This founder and CEO of half a dozen companies is always famous for doing unusual things. And when he sent a Tesla Roadster to space, people thought it was the craziest thing they've ever sent to space, and it doesn't make sense to waste that much money for a dummy object to be sent to space. But believe me, it actually helped SpaceX in assessing many things, and they are collecting data even today after more than 2 years. So let's discuss, why did Elon Musk send a Tesla Roadster to space? In today's video of DiscoverZen. In March 2017, SpaceX's founder Elon Musk said that because the launch of the new Falcon Heavy vehicle was risky, it would carry the silliest thing we can imagine. In June 2017, one of his Twitter followers suggested that that silly thing be a Tesla Model S, to which Musk replied, "Suggestions welcome." In December 2017, he announced that the payload would be his personal Midnight Cherry Tesla Roadster. Later that month, photos of the car prior to payload encapsulation were released. One of the test flight objectives was to demonstrate that the new rocket could carry a payload as far as the orbit of Mars. Elon Musk's Tesla Roadster is an electric sports car that served as the dummy payload for February 2018's Falcon Heavy test flight and became an artificial satellite of the sun. Starman, a mannequin dressed in a spacesuit, occupies the driver's seat. The car and rocket are products of Tesla and SpaceX, respectively, both companies headed by Elon Musk. The 2008 model Roadster is personally owned by and previously used by Musk for commuting to work. It is the first production car launched into space and the first to orbit the sun. The car, mounted on the rocket's second stage, acquired enough velocity to escape Earth's gravity and enter the elliptical heliocentric orbit crossing the orbit of Mars. The orbit reaches a maximum distance of the sun at an aphelion of 1.66 astronomical units. During the early portion of this voyage, just outside of Earth's atmosphere, live video is transmitted back to Mission Control Center and live streamed for slightly over 4 hours. Advertising analysts noted Musk's sense of brand management and use of new media for his decision to launch a Tesla into space. Musk explained he wanted to inspire the public about the possibility of something happening in space as part of his larger vision for spreading humanity to other planets. Roadster as payload. The Roadster was attached to the upper stage of the Falcon Heavy rocket. The car was permanently mounted on the rocket in an inclined position above the payload adapter. Tubular structures were added to mount front and side cameras. Positioned in the driver's seat is Starman, a full-scale human mannequin clad in SpaceX pressure spacesuit. It was placed with the right hand on the steering wheel and the left elbow resting on the open window seal. The mannequin was named after the David Bowie song Starman, and the car's sound system was set before launch to continuously loop on the Bowie song Space Oddity. There is a copy of Douglas Adams' novel The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy in the glove box, along with references to the book in the form of a towel and a sign on the dashboard that reads, "Don't panic." A Hot Wheels miniature Roadster with a miniature Starman is mounted on the dashboard. A plaque bearing the names of the employees who worked on the project is placed underneath the car, and a message on the vehicle's circuit board reads, "Made on Earth by humans." The car also carries a copy of the Isaac Asimov Foundation trilogy on a 5D optical disc, a proof of concept for high-density, long-lasting data storage donated to Musk by the Arch Mission Foundation. Trajectory. The U.S. Office of Commercial Space Transportation issued the test flight's launch license on February 2, 2018. The rocket lifted off from Launch Complex 39A at Kennedy Space Center at 1500 hours and 45 minutes Eastern Standard Time on February 6. The upper stage supporting the car was initially placed in an Earth parking orbit. It spent 6 hours coasting through the Van Allen radiation belts, thereby demonstrating a new capability requested by the U.S. Air Force for direct insertion of heavy intelligence satellites into geostationary orbit. Then, the upper stage performed a second boost to reach the desired escape trajectory. The launch was live streamed, and video feeds from space showed the Roadster at various angles with Earth in the background. This was thanks to a few cameras placed both inside and outside the car. Musk had estimated the car's battery would last over 12 hours, but the live stream ran for just over 4 hours, thus ending before the final boost out of Earth orbit. The Roadster is in a heliocentric orbit, This crosses the orbit of Mars and reaches a distance of 1.66 AU from the Sun, with an inclination of roughly 1 degree to the ecliptic plane, compared to Mars at 1.85 degrees inclination. This trajectory by design cannot intercept Mars, so the car will neither fly by Mars nor enter into an orbit around Mars. The maximum speed of the car relative to the Sun will be approximately 121,000 kilometers per hour at perihelion. This was the second object launched by SpaceX to leave Earth orbit after the Discover mission to the Earth-Sun L1 Lagrangian point. Even if the rocket had targeted an actual Mars transfer orbit, the car couldn't have been placed into orbit around Mars. This is because the upper stage that carries it isn't equipped with the necessary propellant, maneuvering, or communication capabilities. This flight simply demonstrated that Falcon Heavy is capable of launching significant payloads towards Mars in potential future missions. Cultural impact. The car in space quickly became a topic for internet memes. Western Australia police distributed a picture of a radar gun aimed at the Roadster whilst above Australia. An attempt was made by Donut Media to launch Hot Wheels Tesla Model X to the stratosphere using a weather balloon. Tusky, a Russian startup, sent a scale model of a Soviet-era Lada carrying a mannequin of Roscosmos head Dmitry Rogozin to an altitude of 20 kilometers to gather test data for the design of the Stratostats. The SpaceX launch livestream reached over 2.3 million concurrent viewers on YouTube, which made it the second most watched live event on the platform. This is behind another space-related event, Felix Baumgartner's jump from the stratosphere in 2012. Future predictions. Simulations over a 3 million year time span found a probability of the Roadster colliding with Earth at approximately 6%, or with Venus at approximately 2.5%. These probabilities of collision are similar to those of other near-Earth objects. The half-life of the tested orbits was calculated as approximately 20 million years, but with trajectories varying significantly following a close approach to the Earth-Moon system in 2091. Musk had originally speculated the car could drift around space for a billion years. According to a chemist, William Carroll, solar radiation, cosmic radiation, and micrometeor impacts will structurally damage the car over time. Radiation will eventually break down any material with carbon-carbon bonds, including carbon fiber parts. Tires, paint, plastic, and leather might last about a year, while carbon fiber parts will last considerably longer. Eventually, though, only the aluminum frame, inert metals, and glass not shattered by meteoroids will remain. In the end, we can say that Starman will likely remain a symbol of SpaceX's imaginative approach to space launches. Now let's discuss, how will SpaceX Starship completely change the aviation industry? Well, actually, let's go ahead and save that for next time on DiscoverZen.